안녕하세요, 여러분. 이번 시간에는 15과 Grammar 15.4 Prospective Non-Modifying Form 같이 공부해요. The prospective non-modifying suffix -을 or -real is a two-shape ending to indicate that a situation is yet to be realized. As for the form of the suffix, when the stem of the predicate ends in a vowel, attach -real. But when the stem ends in a consonant, attach 을. Okay, let us look at the example. 이번 주말에 할 일이 많아요. 자, this weekend 할 일. So here 할 is a non-modifying form which modifies the following noun 일, work. 자, 할, which comes from 하 plus 일, right? So to do. So works that you will do. In this context, so the question literally means, do you have a lot of works that you will do this weekend? And more natural translation, do you have a lot of works to do this weekend? 네, 좀 많아요. Yeah, yes, I have a lot. Here, 할 일, you can translate it as works to do or things to do. Okay? 자, 2번 생일 파티에 입을 옷이 없어요. 자, for this a birthday party, 입을 옷. 자, 입을 is modifying following noun 옷, clothes. 자, 입을, which comes from 입 plus prospective non-modifying suffix, right? 자, 입 뭐예요? So to wear. So 입을 옷, it literally means the clothes that I will wear. Okay? And the whole sentence means, I don't have clothes that I will wear for or on the birthday party. So more naturally, I don't have clothes to wear on the birthday party. So here, 입을 옷, you can translate it as clothes to wear. Okay? 자, 3번. 다음 학기에 한국어 203을 가르치실 분은 이 선생님이세요. 자, 다음 학기 next semester Korean 203 가르치실 분. 자, 가르치실 is a non-modifying form which modifies the following noun 분. 자, 분 뭐예요? 그렇죠? So honorific form of 사람, right? The person. 자, 가르치실 which comes from 가르치 plus 시 honorific subject honorific and prospective non-modifying suffix. Subject honorific marker is attached because the subject is 선생님, honorable person, right? So 가르치실 분, it means the person who will teach. 자, 뭘 가르쳐요? 한국어 203 언제? 다음 학기에, next semester. The person who will teach Korean 203 next semester is 누구예요? 이 선생님이세요. Professor Lee. 괜찮아요? 자, again, 여기서 가르치실 분, the person to teach, or the person who will teach. Okay? 자, 우리 같이 연습해요. Fill in the blanks with 을 or 리을 form. 자, you have four sentences, and each sentence contain the predicate in parenthesis. Change each predicate into 리을 을 form. Okay? I'll give you 10 minutes. Write down your answers on your textbook, page 160. After you finish it, come back to this video. 시작하세요. 자, 그럼 우리 같이 해봐요. 자, 1번. 오늘 저녁에 먹다 음식이 없어요. There is no food. 자, 어떤 음식이에요? 먹을 음식. 먹을 음식이 없어요. There is no food to eat. 언제? 오늘 저녁에. This evening. 자, 2번. 내년 여름에 한국에 가다 친구가 많이 있어요. 자, 친구가 friends 많이 있어요. I have a lot of friends or there are many friends. 어떤 친구? 갈 친구. 그렇죠? 갈 친구. 어디에 가요? 한국에 갈 친구. 언제? 내년 여름에. Next summer. I have a lot of friends who will go to Korea next summer. Make sense? 자, 3번. 다음 학기에 졸업하다, graduate, 학생이 두 사람 있어요. So there are two students. 그렇죠? 학생이 두 사람 있어요. There are two students. 어떤 학생이에요? 졸업할 학생. 졸업할 학생. There are two students who will graduate 언제? 다음 학기에. Next semester. Okay? So it's in the future. 자, 4번. 목이 말라요. I'm thirsty. 자, 마시다. 물좀 주세요. Please give me water. 자, 어떤 물이에요? 자, 마실 물. 그렇죠? Water that I will drink or the water to drink. Give me some water to drink. 자, 우리 또 연습해요. Convert the following sentences into noun phrases with prospective noun modifying form. Look at the example. 친구한테 선물을 줄 거예요. 자, this sentence is in the future tense, right? So I will give a present to my friend. So you will give a present to your friend, right? And if you convert this sentence into a noun phrase about present, then you would say 친구한테 줄 선물. Here the present that I will give to my friend. Makes sense? So here it's a prospective noun modifying suffix. So you have three sentences to convert. I'll give you 10 minutes. Write down your answers on a blank paper. After you finish it, come back to this video. 자, 시작하세요. 자, 그럼 우리 같이 해봐요. 자, 첫 번째. 아침에 빵을 먹을 거예요. 자, I will eat the bread in the morning. 그렇죠? So let's convert this sentence into noun phrase about the bread. Then how did you change it? 아침에 먹을 빵, right? The bread that I will eat in the morning, right? 을 prospect noun modifying suffix. 자, 두 번째. 여름에 학생들이 졸업할 거예요. 자, in the summer, students will graduate. 그렇죠? So change it into a noun phrase about 학생들, right? 자, 뭐예요? 여름에 졸업할 학생들, students who will graduate in the summer. Make sense? You see the 리을 noun prospective noun modifying suffix. Finally, 내년에 대학원에 다닐 거예요. So in next year, I will attend graduate school, or I will go to the graduate school next year. So it's about 대학원. So how can you change the sentence into noun phrase? 내년에 다닐 대학원. So the graduate school that I will attend next year, or the graduate school that I will go to next year. Okay, here again you see real prospective noun modifying suffix. 괜찮아요? 자, 여기까지입니다. 우리 다음 비디오에서 만나요.